Just finished my workout down here in my basement gym, and my little area here is actually clean for once. So I figure no better time than right now to do a full walkthrough of the home gym. I will break down all the equipment that I have, what I think is essential, and what is just nice to have. A few notes just on home gyms in general. I spent about $3,500 on everything. So the floor mats, the weights, everything you see, about $3,500, give or take. I'm gonna put links to everything that I bought in the description. There are different tiers of home gym equipment. For example, I don't have anything by Rogue. All of their stuff is very pricey because it's made to just really beat the hell out of it. I have lower grade stuff here that's still really good quality, but there's different price tiers to home gym equipment. Titan and Valor are the two big ones that I've purchased through. If you are looking to build a home gym, I guess two big notes. The first one is you don't need to plan to spend all of that money at once. Build it slowly. I started March 2020, I was forced to work out from home. I had been going to a gym for 12, 13 years or so. So I absolutely loved the gym and I had no plans to work out at home, but the pandemic kind of forced me to. I started with just resistance bands, which was a nightmare for me. I hated it at first. Grew to like it. It kind of taught me that your muscles don't know specific weights. You get so used to doing specific weights in the gym and your muscles only know resistance. They don't know that you're curling 20 pounds. They just know the feeling of 20 pounds worth of resistance. So if you get resistance bands, you could mimic that really easily. So I was doing resistance bands for, I think, 3 months or so. That was all I had. And I still got really good workouts. I didn't lose any muscle. I didn't lose any strength. Resistance bands can be very great to use. So let's run through, oh goodness. Let's run through what I bought. So over the course of, I'd say, a year and a half or so, I've put together my home gym here. So it's a slow process. Don't plan to just do it all at once. I started with the resistance bands. Then I got a hand-me-down, a small bar with weights that don't fit it. And I was bench pressing on an ottoman and using stools as my rack. Very dangerous, and for the record, everything I'm gonna show you right now, very dangerous, don't recommend, kids, please be careful. And then I was using the bottom of a chair as a weight tree. Ooh. From there, I ended up getting an adjustable bench, the one that I'm still sitting on here, so that's been a full year I've been using this guy, which I will show you. And I was using two chairs as my rack to bench with. Again, very dangerous. And then things started coming together. And then I bought this rack. I bought a pull-down machine and yada yada. And then I just have slowly built up some stuff from there. But those were the main ones, just to show you that I didn't have a nice setup for a year or so and it still worked out. So you can plan to build it slowly. You don't have to buy everything all at once. Like I said, I spent about $3,500 or so, and a lot of people will say, like, that's so much money. I can go to a gym for $20, $30 a month. But don't compare it apples to apples because it's not the same. Having a home gym, it's a luxury. It's something nice to have, and it really depends on your preferences and your life. So for example, if you have a commute to the gym, that is saving you time. If you have a really busy schedule, you might be a single parent and you don't really have time to go to the gym. So having it in your house to squeeze in short workouts during the day, I mean, that's gonna be a huge benefit just for your overall health, being able to work out at home. I didn't think I was gonna like home workouts, but I love it. I get to play all my 90s throwback music. I have no distractions here. No offense to anyone that goes to the gym that likes to chat, but I don't like to do that. I like to be in and out in an hour. I don't have to wait for any machines. I really, really like this. I like the luxury of having it just in my basement. There are downsides, of course. I don't have a spotter for one. Let's do a quick run around here of everything that I have. I will show you. So this is just a small section of my basement. I have a full basement here, storage. Sorry, my light's blocking it. I have storage back there. This is just a little corner of my basement. When I record videos, it looks bigger than it is. These mats here are 4 by 6, 4 feet by 6 feet long. So that means that's 12 feet by 8 feet. So that's not a big area. I have my full rack. I got the weights on it. I have two bars, which I'll show you in a minute, but I have my regular bar and I have a multi-grip bar. So this is where I do the majority of my stuff. And then I ended up getting, as well as my adjustable bench that I have here, I have a flat bench. And these are my cables that I just recently got, absolutely love. I have adjustable dumbbells. I have a leg extension leg curl machine, a landmine attachment that I just tucked over there because it didn't fit on my rack. And then we have my weight tree, a seated calf machine, and that's it. And we turn around and here we are. So if you are starting your own home gym, this is where you start. The rack, an adjustable bench, and a barbell. This is a 2-inch by 2-inch rack. This was from Titan. They don't sell this specific one anymore. Most racks you'll buy are gonna be 3 inches by 3 inches. And one other thing that I've learned is that the hole sizes can vary. So if you're buying a rack, something to keep in mind is if you're gonna want attachments, there are dip attachments, there are like the spotter arms here. There are different attachments you can buy. So keep in mind that the hole sizes are gonna be different. So this rack that I have, it's 2 inches by 2 inches with 5/8 of an inch hole. Most racks you're gonna see are gonna be 3 by 3 and then the holes are gonna be 1 inch. Just keep that in mind that it does vary. So if you're looking for a rack with compatible attachments, that's something you're gonna wanna note. So the reason you want one of these, if you're working out at home, is that it will spot you. It has these arms built in. So if you are benching, if you're squatting, you can put these arms at the lowest possible spot. And if you happen to fail, if it's at the very bottom, you'll be able to bail on the weight and it won't crush you. So if you're benching, you put it so it's right at your chest. And if the weight's too heavy to lift it, then you can just rack it and slide out. I got a Weider weight set from Dick's Sporting Goods. Far from perfect. It's got a whole bunch of nicks and, I mean, it's not the prettiest. These were the weights that I bought. I got a set of 300 pounds and it came with a bar. It was very cheap. With weights in general, that's gonna be one of the more expensive things you buy. The only way you're gonna save money with weights is if you go on Marketplace or Craigslist and you find somebody getting them or getting rid of them for really cheap. Pretty rare, especially right now. Expect to pay at least $1 per pound of weight. That's the absolute cheapest you're gonna find. Cheapest you're gonna find. So I found a set of 300 pounds that came with the bar that was $300 flat, which was a great deal. If you look up reviews for this weight set, the reviews are really negative because of stuff like this, like all the nicks and whatnot. I don't care about that with just the home gym stuff in general, equipment, weights, all that kind of stuff. It's not gonna be quite as nice as when you go to the gym, but it's gonna be significantly cheaper. If you care about things being real pretty and matching, then you're gonna have to spend more. These were cheap, but the point of that, anyway, was that it came with a bar, and the cheap bar that the weight sets will come with, it's a little bit thicker and the grip on it is not very good. So I sold that bar and I bought myself a totally separate one. This one's from Valor. It is a black bar, which I really like, and the grip on it is really nice for deadlifting. It's got a little bit of give to it, so the bar will bend a little bit when you're lifting, which is great for me. The multi-grip bar here, it's just a nice to have. I bought that one from Titan. You certainly don't need that. That is to do close grip kind of stuff. I really like switching out my bench, doing close grip bench. And then one other thing that I want to show you is the lever arms that I bought for this. Again, not a necessity, but absolutely love these things. I'm gonna plan to do a video exclusive for the lever arms because there's so much you can do with them. They're called lever arms or jammer arms. They attach right to the rack. The only issue, so like I said, I have a Titan rack that they don't make anymore. That's 2 inches by 2 inches. I couldn't find any lever arms that fit it. These Bells of Steel ones, their rack sizes are a little bit bigger. So it took me a while to figure it out, but where this attaches to my rack, I had to put a little piece of wood here and I put little like furniture stoppers that I taped to add a little bit of width. Basically all that is to say that I needed to get creative to make this fit. If you buy Titan's like 3x3 rack, for example, they sell their own lever arms, so you don't have to worry about that. But I just wanted to show you that it wasn't a perfect fit, so I did need to be a little bit creative. So these hang off of the rack here, and there's so much you can do with them. Any machine you do at the gym, you can mimic with these. So think of chest press machines, shoulder press, rows. I purchased an extra weight attachment, so it pushes the lever arm out. So one of my favorite things to do here is a chest press. So depending on how inclined you go, you can do an incline chest press or a regular. And because I'm away from the rack now, the resistance is so much better. So you can throw a plate on there, 25 pounds, whatever. You'll have to feel it out because this is different than what you're used to. So now with the lever arm out, this holds it in place. So the starting position's here. And then you can do shoulder press. So you can do even flat bench if you lower this. I've done vertical leg press with these by lowering them. But by using these chains, it allows so much more versatility, so you don't have to just be pushing away from the rack. You can start out here, and seriously, you can mimic pretty much any machine that you do at the gym, which to me, this has been absolutely incredible to have. This is from Valor. This is called a functional trainer. It has the cables on each side that are very easily adjustable here. It's got a pulley at the bottom and a pulley at the top for lat pull downs. And it's got the handles at the top for pull ups, which I very much like. This was one of the last things I purchased. So of course, not a necessity for a home gym. Necessities: adjustable bench, rack, bar, and then weights, obviously. This one's just a nice to have, but the cables here on the end, I was worried that because this is a smaller machine, I was worried that for something like flies, it wouldn't be wide enough for me. You can stretch really, really wide and then still do flies easily. So you're not stuck doing it here because these swing out. You can pull from that wider spot, and it works just as good as if you have at the gym the cable crossover that are really far apart. This machine takes standard plates. So standard plates are plates with a 1-inch hole in the center. It's confusing. I didn't know this when I was starting my home gym. I assumed that standard meant the plates you see at the gym. They're the standard ones. The ones you see at the gym are Olympic plates. They're made for a barbell with 2-inch holes. Standard plate. Let's see if I can lift this up. Olympic plate. If you have a machine that takes standard plates, like this one does, you have the option to put an adapter on it. So you can slide this onto the machine there, and then you can use Olympic plates. So you can always go bigger with it, but you can't shrink it down. So if you buy one that takes Olympic plates, you can't then use the standard plates. For me, the reason I wanted to get one that takes the standard plates is because I really like doing exercises back to back. So if I'm using my rack over there and if I'm benching, for example, and I'm using my Olympic plates on the bar, I want to be able to come over here and do lat pull downs. So by having a set of standard plates and a set of Olympic plates, I can come over here and do my exercises back to back without having to take the weight off and put it on here. I can keep weight on this machine and then go over there. I feel like what are those people called at the airport? Whatever they're called. That's what I feel like. The standard plates also go on these adjustable dumbbells. I bought a set of the smaller ones and then a set of longer ones. It allows me to have a set of heavy dumbbells and a set of light dumbbells. This is a 60-pound dumbbell right now. If you were to do anything with this, it's got daggers on the end. That's the downside to the adjustable dumbbells. I found these on Amazon. I haven't checked before recording this if they're still available or what the deal is with these, but this is called the dumbbell capper. So if I was doing whatever exercise I'm doing, this is too heavy, and then you can put it down right on your leg and you're not gonna stab yourself in the leg. And then the alternative, the other type of adjustable dumbbells are the ones that kind of twist, like the power blocks or something else. But they have the ones that twist that I don't think the ends of it would stab through your leg. You can buy a full rack of dumbbells, but like I said, it does get very expensive. So this was a good way to save money. I guess this is a good opportunity to show you as well. This rack comes with very standard pull-down bar. I bought a rope attachment, the V-bar, a wide grip pull-down attachment. I'll link all those that I bought. It comes with standard ones, so you don't have to buy it. It comes with handles. But even something like this, a curl bar. I purchased this one separate. And this is what I want to show you. I use this actually as my leg pad. But what I'll do is adjust it so I can slide in right here. And then that's my leg pad. And then as I pull from the top, this stays nice and tight. I didn't adjust it correctly now because I'm trying to do it quick. But that will hold me down. So I've tried going heavy and that does work really well. So if you were worried that the cable machine is not going to be able to hold you down as you're doing pull downs, do something like this. That's why I recommend buying one with the attachment at the bottom as well. If you have just at the top, you're going to have to get really creative. I didn't really want to drill and put leg pads in and try to figure all that out. This was just a very simple solution. My leg extension machine that I have an entire video about that I will link to. If you have a squat rack with a bar, you can do squats, deadlifts, lunges. This is really just a luxury item. For me, there are some days that my voice has cracked like 3 times. For me, there are some days that I have a hard time getting into the workout. So the idea of just doing squats and deadlifts, it's just really hard to get going. I really like having alternatives when I'm just not feeling it for the day. Doing things that are a little bit less intense are more appealing. With the cable machine, I can do kickbacks and certain things too, which has been really great. But with this, I really missed doing leg extensions, leg curls at the gym. This is a very smooth machine. This one is standard plates as well. So again, if I'm squatting with the Olympic weights, I have the standard plates here and I can do my leg extensions, which have been fantastic, but I do have a full video breaking down. There are 15 different exercises that I do with this. And then I do have the seated calf machine that I don't feel like I need to demonstrate. I actually found that on Overstock. It was on sale for $100. It was one of those things that the reviews were horrible. It was really cheap. And then I bought it. I was like, this is actually kind of great. When you're forced to work out at home and you don't have equipment, you learn that anything can be used for gym purposes. So I actually had, what was I using? I was using like the top of a chair. I detached the chair, put the cushion down, put weights on there, and was sitting on a step and doing seated calf raises like that. So once you start doing that and then you get a machine, even if it's cheap, you realize that that is way better than the alternative. So I like that seated calf machine. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to link to it because it's some off-brand Overstock thing. It's certainly not a necessity. I have just had tiny calves my whole life and I like working out calves. So I bought a seated calf machine and $100 is really cheap. And the other thing I have over there is the weight tree that again, it's just a nice to have. If you have a rack with the pegs on it though, you can very easily put the weight on there. And I bought myself, this is just a flat bench because I like benching heavy. And when you go with the adjustable benches here, once you go flat, there is quite a big gap here. So when you sit down, your butt kind of just falls in. I didn't realize that that was a thing with adjustable benches. There are, I think Rep sells a no gap bench, but it's like $500, something crazy. I think this bench was like $100. You can put something down here. Like I had used a washcloth to kind of bridge this gap, but I ended up buying the flat bench there because it doesn't have a gap. So having a flat bench and an adjustable bench is a good idea, I think. But if you only have an adjustable bench, that is totally fine. That will work. And then of course, the decor. I had a mirror back there. Bad idea. I can show you the videos of the horribleness I experienced, but mirrors, well one, I learned that you don't need a mirror in the squat rack. It kind of throws off your form because you're just watching yourself. So I have sporadic mirrors around here that I just happen to have, but originally I was just balancing mirrors in the squat rack. I'll show you what that looked like. It was very dangerous, it was very stupid. Don't do what I did. If you have questions, if you have comments, let me know. I'll do my best to help. But when it comes to home gyms, you don't need a whole lot. Like I said, you don't need everything I have, but get yourself a rack, an adjustable bench, and a bar to start. You're always gonna find stuff that you can upgrade. It's gonna be a lifelong process, but the gym's yours. This is my gym. I get to do what I want with it. I love it. Working out at home might not be for you, and that's totally fine. It doesn't have to be. There are plenty of gyms out there for that purpose, but start small, try it out. If you like it, build it up from there. You might end up with a really nice home gym. I never thought I was gonna be a home gym person, but I love the setup and I don't think I'm going back. That's a bad sign off. I don't have a sign off. Anyway, until the next video.